I love to look back at old recruiting classes and see which players panned out and which guys ended up being bust. In my opinion, there is no position more fascinating than the quarterback spot, and today we're going to take a look back at every 4-star quarterback from the 2015 recruiting class and briefly talk about their career and what happened to them. But before we get started, be sure to subscribe if you love college football, like if you want to support the channel, suggest what I should do next, and turn on post notifications so you never miss another upload. Now let's get started. I've been having hood dreams. We'll be using 24/7 Sports for today's video, and before we get started, I want to talk about a few noteworthy guys who were part of this class but were not 4-star recruits. It'll go to show you that not every good quarterback is a big-time recruit, and this list includes some pretty good and memorable names. It includes Clemson's Kelly Bryant, Michigan State's Brian Lewerke, Virginia Tech's Ryan Willis, West Virginia's David Sills, Syracuse's Eric Dungy, Virginia's Bryce Perkins, Wisconsin's Alex Hornibrook, Colorado's Steven Montez, Buffalo's Tyree Jackson, and Duke's Daniel Jones. There were some pretty big names on that list, but now let's talk about the 23 quarterbacks who were given a 4-star rating. Kyle Shurmur was the final 4-star in the class of 2015 and the son of NFL head coach Pat Shurmur, and he decided to take his talents to Vanderbilt. He started immediately for the Commodores and will go down as the best statistical quarterback in school history. He was a really good 4-year player and would sign with the Kansas City Chiefs, but he was never expected to have much of a pro career. Dwayne Lawson is a guy who I personally had never heard of before today, and he took his talents to Virginia Tech. At 6'6", he was highly touted, but after a failed drug test, he decided to leave Virginia Tech and went to Garden City Community College. After his time there, he committed to Illinois, but never would qualify academically, and he ended his football career at Missouri Southern State. Jason Pellerin was a big-time recruit coming out of high school, and after he became a star at New Iberia Catholic High School, he chose to go to Ole Miss. In his time there, he was mostly the backup to Chad Kelly, and then he was the backup to Jordan Tamu, and primarily would play on special teams, and just never really got a chance. He was all over the SEC honor roll list though, and was a very hard-working kid, so he'll definitely be fine, but he never got a chance to shine at Ole Miss. The son of the legendary Mark Rypien, Brett Rypien was a very talented player coming out of high school, and instead of choosing a big-time Power 5 program, he committed to play for Boise State, and he was a great player there. He started 4 years at Boise State, threw for over 13,000 yards, and led the Broncos to 3 straight 10-plus win seasons. He went undrafted, but he has gotten a few chances with the Broncos, and I think he can be a career backup in the NFL. He's the most underrated quarterback from the 2015 class, in my opinion, and he has done very well for himself. James Morgan is one of the more interesting players on this list, as he chose to play for Bowling Green coming out of high school because of head coach Dino Babers. He was an off-and-on starter for the Eagles, but he wanted to transfer and go elsewhere eventually. He emailed multiple schools, but only Florida International wanted him, and he became a star for them. He was so good that he was drafted in the 4th round of the 2020 draft by the Jets, and he should be a career backup. Everyone knows Lamar Jackson now, but at one point, people were skeptical he could even play quarterback. He would choose Louisville, where he'd break out into a star and won the Heisman Trophy, as we all know. He was drafted by the Ravens, and has even won an MVP trophy so far. He's the second best quarterback from the 2015 class, and good for him for proving the doubters wrong. Sharian Jones is one of the biggest busts from the 2015 class, as he was a big-time recruit coming out of high school and chose to take his talents to Tennessee. He redshirted, chose to transfer to Colorado, and then came back to Tennessee, but then chose to transfer again and ultimately would never play for the Volunteers, so he went the JUCO route and would eventually end up at New Mexico. He started 7 games for the Lobos, but he is most known for his charge of indecent exposure in front of a woman in a parking garage, and it's pretty safe to say things did not end up going the way he probably would have liked them to. After the Allen brothers left Fayetteville, Ty Story was supposed to be the next man up for Arkansas after the blue chip recruit chose the Razorbacks. He started 8 games for Arkansas during the Chad Morris era, and it was just not good timing for him. He struggled so much that he decided to transfer to Western Kentucky, where he took over the starting job, and then in a road game against Arkansas, he actually beat them. He was a solid player and didn't live up to the hype, but he did have a solid career. As we all know, Joe Burrow wanted to go to Nebraska, but he chose to stay home and play for Ohio State after a dominant career in Athens, Ohio. He never really got a chance to play at Ohio State behind Dwayne Haskins and JT Barrett, and he left for LSU. He was solid in 2018 for the Tigers, but in 2019, he had one of the best seasons in college football history as he won a title, the Heisman, and became the number 1 overall pick. He was having a great rookie year with the Bengals before a season-ending injury, and I fully expect him to be back and better than ever in 2021. After Josh Dobbs, Tennessee had to find a new quarterback, and Jarrett Garantano, Will McBride, and Quentin Dormady all had a chance to win the job. Dormady was a big-time recruit coming out of high school and even won his first career start against Georgia, but he later fell off and decided to transfer to Houston, where he would never play. He then left for Central Michigan, where he would start 10 games and passed over 2,000 yards. But he had a pretty interesting football career. We all know Sam Darnold as a top 10 pick who was a star at USC, and that's exactly what he was. After becoming a Trojan, he had to wait his turn, and after Max Brown never panned out, Darnold took over and became a star. The highlight of his career, in my opinion, was the Rose Bowl victory, and he was drafted to be the franchise quarterback of the Jets. But they are a dumpster fire, so I have no idea what his future holds. He would definitely live up to the hype, though, and was a great player at USC. DeAndre Francois is one of the most fascinating and sad stories of the 2015 class, as he had a ton of hype when he committed to Florida State, and after Jameis Winston tore it up as a Knoll, Francois was next. He played great in 2016 and looked super promising going into 2017, but he injured his patella versus Alabama and would miss the entire season. He got into trouble off the field as well and was eventually dismissed, but he would try to save his career by walking on at Florida Atlantic, and that just never panned out. He ended up going to Hampton instead, and as of 2020, he signed with Fan-Controlled Football. Francois could have been the next great quarterback for the Seminoles and had all the potential in the world, but that injury ruined everything, and it's become a huge what-if. Jake Browning is the all-time leader in high school football touchdown passes and chose to take his talents to Washington after tearing it up on California's high school football circuit. He started as a freshman, broke numerous Washington records, and even led them to a college football playoff appearance. He's one of those great college quarterbacks, but he was never really going to be an NFL guy. He signed with the Vikings as an undrafted free agent, but nothing ever happened for him in the NFL, as he would bounce around from practice squad to practice squad. He was a lot of fun to watch at Washington, and he definitely deserves a video of his own soon. Drew Locke's dad went to Mizzou back in the day, so the Tigers were always going to have a good shot at landing him. He became a big-time recruit after he tore it up at Lee's Summit High School in Kansas City, and he was one of the top quarterback recruits in the country. He stayed home to play for Mizzou and tore it up for 4 years there. He did struggle as a freshman, but broke the SEC record for touchdown passes in a season at one point, and will go down as one of the best players in Mizzou history. Some say he was overrated, but he did get drafted in the second round by the Denver Broncos, and he's gotten a chance to make multiple starts. He has shown flash, but he's also struggled, and his time to become a franchise quarterback is honestly kind of running out. As you guys know, he is my favorite college football quarterback of all time, and he is a legend in my book. Juwan Jennings is a volunteer legend, as he became a big-time wide receiver for the team, caught the Hail Mary pass in the Georgia game, and became one of the best statistical pass catchers in school history. He was good enough to get selected with the 217th pick in the 7th round by the 49ers, and we will see if he ever gets a real chance to make a name for himself in the NFL. Travis Johnson is another name I've never heard of before making today's video, but he was the 8th best quarterback in 2015, and he chose to commit to Oregon. He redshirted in 2016 and lost the job in 2017, so he decided to transfer away from Oregon and went to Riverside College. He then packed his bags again and went to Montana State, where he became a star player who did a little bit of everything. After his time there, he got a chance to be a part of the scout team for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, and he now has a Super Bowl ring. He battled an injury, got benched at JUCO, changed positions, and got a Super Bowl ring, and I would say that's a pretty eventful career and not bad. Brady White was a big-time recruit coming out of high school, and he chose to commit to Arizona State to be with Mike Norvell. After suffering injuries, he followed Norvell to Memphis, where he has since became a star player and continued the impressive line of Tiger quarterbacks. He was top 6 in both passing yards and touchdowns in 2020, and he declared for the 2021 NFL Draft. He will likely get drafted late, and he may be the longest tenured player from the 2015 class. Ricky Town is the second biggest bust from the 2015 class, as he was a star in high school and chose to take his talents to USC. He stayed there for 1 year before he left for Arkansas, and he didn't do much there, to be honest. After that, he went the JUCO route and eventually Pitt, and he became a backup quarterback there, but then just vanished from football. He barely ever saw the field in college, and it's sad to see that his career never took off or that he even really got a chance. Coming in as a 4-star recruit from the 2015 class, Brandon Wimbush was a big-time name and was actually so good that he committed to play for Notre Dame. He was seen as the future of the team, and he battled it out for the starting job with Ian Book. He got some chances and started some games for the Irish, but he eventually transferred out of the program and joined UCF, but he would never get a chance to play there. He has now started a marketing agency for athletes and influencers, and I'm curious to see how this all turns out for him, and I hope the business succeeds. He was seen as the best high school football quarterback ever, as Kyler Murray was a 5-star recruit and one of the most sought-after players from the 2015 class. He eventually chose Kevin Sumlin in A&M, but after a bad first year, he left the program and Oklahoma gladly welcomed him. He became a superstar with the Sooners and won the Heisman Trophy. He then became the number one overall pick to the Arizona Cardinals, and he looks like one of the top young quarterbacks in the NFL. Blake Barnett is one of the most talked about college football busts of this decade, and he had a pretty weird career. He was a five-star who chose Alabama, but then lost a job to Jalen Hurts, and decided to pack his bags and head to Arizona State. When he got to Tempe, he would lose the job to Manny Wilkins, and he would eventually become a backup to Dylan Sterling Cole in 2019, so he'd lead the program again, this time to USF. He joined Charlie Strong in Tampa, and got a chance to start, and actually had a great 2018 season, where he had the fifth best passing season in Bulls history. He struggled in 2019, and as far as I know, he is done with football. Josh Rosen had the most buzz of any quarterback in the 2015 class, and when he stepped foot on UCLA's campus, he was already big time. As a freshman, he was a star and the top freshman quarterback in the country, according to most people. As a sophomore, he got injured in October and missed most of the year. As a junior, he led them to an amazing comeback win against and set a new career high in passing yards and passing touchdowns. He left for the 2018 NFL Draft, where he was taken with the 10th overall pick, but he got put on one of the worst teams in the NFL with the Cardinals, and then in 2019, he got screwed again with the Dolphins, and now he is basically done and out of the NFL. We are now at the last quarterback of the day, and he was the top-ranked gunslinger in the class of 2015. His name was Jarrett Stidham, and he was a prodigy. He surprisingly chose Baylor and came in as the backup to Seth Russell. He would start some games, though, after Russell got injured, and eventually Jarrett would decide to transfer to Auburn. He played 2 years for the Tigers and even won an SEC West championship, but he decided to jump to the NFL a year early and was drafted with the 133rd pick in the fourth round by the Patriots. When Tom Brady left, he was potentially seen as the successor to him, but in the moments he has played so far, he's looked pretty bad, and I don't think he will be in the NFL much longer. Well, that wraps up today's video, and it was a lot of fun to make. Who is your favorite quarterback from the 2015 class, and who is the biggest bust in your eyes? Let me know another topic or series I should do next, and before you go, if you want to support the channel, be sure to give it a like, subscribe if you're new, and check out my ultimate college football playlist and all my What Happened To videos. I hope to see you guys again soon, but until next time, peace.